Good afternoon, everybody. Dear students, today we are going to learn one more parts of speech. That is third parts of speech. After noun and pronoun, we are going to learn verb. What is verb? It is not necessary on the part of every sentence that there should be verb. Yavattu saha ella vakyadallu verb irbekantara. If there is any work, verb is nothing but work. Kriye, we call it as kriya pada. For every verb, a noun is very necessary. Unless there is a noun, the bridge is working. Bridge is noun. Working, that is verb. Then likewise, fan is rotating. Fan is verb and rotating is verb. Therefore, for every work, there should be a noun or a pronoun. A noun or a pronoun. Otherwise, the verb will not work. Understand all of you. Therefore, verb is, what is verb then? A verb which shows some action of the noun. A verb is a word which shows some action of the noun. Some movement should be there. Take for example, the chalk piece is on the table, I am telling. But if I push this chalk piece, the teacher is pushing the chalk piece. That push itself is verb and the teacher is the noun. But if it is simply there on the table, that chalk piece, there will be no verb. The chalk piece is on the table. Understand the difference between using verb and not using the verb. That is very important. A boy is there. No question of verb there. The boy is running. It means the boy, noun, running. He is doing some action. Seeing, it may be seeing, it may be watching, it may be running, it may be skipping, or anything, all are verbs. They are called, take for example, you see, a noun is very necessary. Therefore, verb is a word which shows some action of the noun. Action of the noun, that is very important. You know the meaning of action. Some action of the noun or pronoun. Namapada athava sarvanama maduva yavude tarada kelasagalu irbeku kannu hinge mitikisidru adu it is verb agutte adaitalla hagagi he is verb anta naavu helteve adaitalla kannu hodithane kannu is now hodithane is verb agutte alli adaitalla hage naavu you see the original words of the verb is called as root verbs anta naavu karithe. We call it as root verbs. Moola shabdagalu athava kriya dhatu. In Kannada it is called as kriya dhatu. You are almost learning even the Kannada grammar by this. Understand? Okay, kriya dhatu. What are those kriya dhatu? Kriya dhatu is see, watch, jump, run, go, come, walk. These words are called, original words are called kriya dhatu or root words. It may take shape. See means see, seeing, had seen, have seen, he saw, had been seeing, has been seeing, will see, shall see, all these things, shall have been seen, all these things. They will take different shapes, but the original word is same. Therefore, these words see, watch, jump, run, go, come, walk, all are called as root words. Root words of the verb. They are called as root words of the verbs. Let's go. Now, how many kinds of verbs we will go next? Therefore, I repeat once again, verb is a word which shows some action of the noun or pronoun. Namapada athava sarvanama maduva kelasagalige kriyapada ennu karayuttare. It is not necessary that every sentence should have a verb. The book is on the table. No question of verb there. The book is moving. there the verb comes. Understand? If it is in a position to move, then the verb comes. Book is now verb. Therefore, now kinds of verbs we go for. Kinds of verbs. Kinds of verb. Very important. Kinds of verb. I will let you know the example. 1 minute. The man killed a snake. Two, the boy opened the window. Third one, Shyamala made a ball. Second set, one. The man died. Two. The girl smiled. Third one. The sun shines. I have written 6 sentences here. 3 sentences, a lengthy sentence, lengthy sentences. 3 sentences, short sentence. Let us study these sentences. The man is now here. Roots of the verb is there. Now, killed is verb. A snake. Snake means how? Snake. What the man killed is snake. That is called as object. Avanu yavudara mele kelsa martano. And what he is doing work is called as object always. Arthakala. And what he is doing is called verb. What he is doing? He is killing. He killed. Who is killing? The man. That is subject. Therefore, there are 3 parts in a sentence. Subject, verb and an object. In the first lesson itself, Rama and Sita, I already told you all these things. A repetition is not necessary for those things. The man killed a snake. Here, I will tell you one thing, dear children. I will close this snake. The man killed. Is that sentence gives a meaning? No, it will not give a meaning. It requires something. It requires something. The man killed. What he killed? The another boy asks. What he killed? The another boy asks. Then you, if you open this, a snake is the answer for that. Therefore, if a verb requires an object to complete its meaning, if a verb requires an object to complete its meaning, is called as transitive verb. A verb which requires an object to complete its meaning is called as a transitive verb. The second sentence, the boy is the noun, opened is the verb. If we close this, what he opened? The question. It is in object. The result is in object. Therefore, the boy opened the window means object window, opened as verb, and the boy is the. Therefore, this is also transitive verb. Here, object is there. This verb requires an object. And this verb also requires an object. Third, Shyamala made a ball. Shyamala, subject, made verb, ball. What he has done, what she has done. A ball is the object. Therefore, a verb which requires an object to complete its meaning. Yava vandu kriyapadakke karma parada purakavada sahayavannu padedo arthavannu kodutado adakke sakarmaka kriyapada endu kareyutteve. Nyapa idkoli kannada. Next, second set. The man died. The girl smiled. The sun shines. Here, no verb is there. No object is there. But it gives good meaning. The man is subject, died is verb. The girl is subject, smiled is verb. The sun is subject, shines is verb. Therefore, a verb which do not require an object to complete its meaning, but gives good meaning of its own, is called as an intransitive verb. Yava vandu kriyaparamu, yava vandu transitive, yava vandu kriyapadamu, karma padada avashyakate illade manushya satta helutare. ಏ ಹುಡುಗಿ ನಕ್ಕಳು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ದ ಸನ್ ಶೈನ್, ಸೂರ್ಯ ಏನು ಪ್ರಕಾರವಾಗಿದ್ದಾನೆ ಅಂತ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ವರ್ಡ್, ಎ ವರ್ಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಡೂ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ ಅನ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಆನ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ವರ್ಡ್. ಅಕರ್ಮಕ ಕ್ರಿಯಾಪದ, ಸಕರ್ಮಕ ಕ್ರಿಯಾಪದ, ಅಕರ್ಮಕ ಕ್ರಿಯಾಪದ. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ? ಶಾಲ್ ವಿ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್? ಓಕೆ, we'll go for third one. The dog is an animal. One, the dog is an animal. The thief always lives in fear. In fear. Next. Third one. She became sad. Fourth one. The man seems tired. Watch carefully. This is a little bit difficult. Watch carefully. The dog is the subject. Here is not a regular verb. It is an auxiliary verb. It acts as regular verb is. And what is this? This is not an object. Object andre adra mele enadru kelsa madbekri. Enadru kelsa madidru matra object. Illadra adu nai kanali anta andre enadu object agutta. ನಾಯಿ ಅನ್ನೋದು. ಇಂಥ ಮಿಸ್ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್, ಅವರಿಗೆ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಅವರು ಹೇಳೋಕ್ಕೂ ಬರೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ನಮ್ಮ ಪಾಠ ಕೇಳೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅವರು. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಐ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಲರ್ನ್ ಅವರ್ ಲೆಸನ್ಸ್. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಮಹಾ ತಪಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ, ಈ ಪಾಠಗಳಿಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಸುಮಾರು 10-15 ವರ್ಷ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಅವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಪಾಠವನ್ನು ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅರ್ಥವತ್ತಾಗಿ ಅವರು ಸಹ ಪಾಠ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೆಸನ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎನ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್, ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಏನು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅವನು. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್? ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ವರ್ಡ್. ದಿಸ್ ಸೀಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ದ ಡಾಗ್ ಈಸ್, ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಸೀಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಆನ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ವರ್ಡ್. ಇದು ಇಂಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ವರ್ಡ್, ಆದರೆ ಪೂರಾ ಇಂಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅದು. ದ ಡಾಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಆನ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ವಿ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಎ ವರ್ಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್, ಎ ವರ್ಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಸೀಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಇಂಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್, ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವರ್ಬ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಡಿಕೇಶನ್. Verb of incomplete predication. ಕನ್ನಡ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಕಂಡು ನನಗೆ, ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾರಾದ್ರೂ ಹೇಳೋರಿದ್ರು ಹೇಳಿ, ನನ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಕಲಿಯಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ತೊಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಹಾ, ಎ ವರ್ಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್, ಎ ವರ್ಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎನ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್. ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವಿ ಹೊರಟೋಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ? ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಎ ವರ್ಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ one more word, a compliment, a presentation. Compliment ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗೊತ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಎ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್, ಎ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್, ಇಡೀ ಅರ್ಥ ಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೆಡಿಕೇಟ್ ಲೆಸನ್ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೆಡಿಕೇಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ದ ಡಾಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಡಿಕೇಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಾಗ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಾಗ ಎ ವರ್ಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ and subject and predicate will be followed by that after completion of the sentence is called as verb of incomplete predication. That is very important. Same thing, the thief always lives in fear. Use his verb. Thief is subject, in fear is the complement. In fear anuva object anta anbutiri na, I stress everything What is the difference between a compliment and he is a boy? And because a boy is not an object, boy is a compliment. Arthayatala. Lives in fear. In fear is compliment. Therefore, it is verb of incomplete predication. Next, she became sad. Became is verb. She is pronoun. Sad is compliment. Arthayatala. Avalu enaru kelasa madidre avaga adu transitive verb agudu. Now it is a compliment. Therefore, it is called as the verb of intransitive verb. The man seems tired. Seems another verb. Man is subject. Tired is complement. Tired on sustagidandre andre sustu annadu object alla. It is not object. Arthayitala. The cow is grazing in the field and field is an object. Grazing is verb. Cow adu ena avadutte transitive verb aagutade. Hagagi therefore a verb which requires a verb to complete its meaning and also to complete subject and predicate. Predicate especially is called as a verb of incomplete predication. You watch twice, you watch thrice, you watch four times and understand this thing. Because a little bit difficult is there. You should know the difference between an object and a complement. That is very important. I think I will repeat again. Verb. Verb is a word which shows some action of the noun or pronoun. The original words, jump, run, all these things are called as root verbs, kriya dhatu. There are three kinds of verbs. They are transitive verb, intransitive verb, and verb of incomplete predication. What is transitive verb? A verb which requires an object to complete its meaning is called as a transitive verb. A verb which do not require an object to complete its meaning, but gives meaning of its own, is called as an intransitive verb. A verb which seems to be intransitive require a word, one more word, to complete its meaning, not an object, is called as verb of incomplete predication. Thus completes the subject and predicate. Tomorrow I will take lesson number 20, that is tense. That is tense, kala, time, kala, tense, kala. Thank you very much. Today the lessons are over. Okay, thank you.